The year ahead is going to be a very exciting time to be an indoor gardener with some brand new technology hitting the market and arguably some others finally coming of age. Firstly, grow lights. They're the engines of our grow rooms, so any breakthroughs in this arena can be huge. One of the most promising technologies, LEDs, is finally up to the mark. You'll be able to find a broader range of high-end LED grow lights available off the shelf. And yes, ones that are actually capable of replacing your metal halides or HPS lights, people. The advantages they will offer will be more along the lines of lower cost of ownership, that is the longer lasting diodes, higher intensity and spectrums tunable by the grower to individual species and even cultivar. A lot of folks will be swapping out their T5 fluorescent tubes for LED strips and vegging their plants solely under retrofitted LEDs. DE lamps will continue to improve. I'll be testing the latest newcomer to the crowd from iHortilux. Meanwhile, nutrient dosing and monitoring equipment will become cheaper, easier to install and use, therefore making it more accessible to hobby growers. I imagine that seasoned gardeners will increasingly move beyond measuring total dissolved solids measured in PPMs or overall conductivity and analyze their nutrient solution at the level of individual ion types. This is an important step forward because while this level of monitoring is already a common practice for many commercial growers, smaller commercial hydroponic growers need to get smarter and more efficient if they want to stay in the game. This process necessitates more tailored nutrient products rather than broad brush-based nutrient products, but it's highly likely you'll more commonly see both in the form of a powder rather than a liquid. Speaking of which, if you haven't yet discovered MaxiGrow, MaxiBloom, and CoolBloom by General Hydroponics, then you're missing a trick. Now, staying on nutrients for a moment longer, brace yourselves for nanotechnology, a science that's supposed to revolutionize many industries, not just hydroponics and agriculture. This is an area of research that I'm actively involved in, so stand by for extremely effective nutrients and supplements based on nanoparticles rather than ionic compounds. Basically, in a nutshell, nanoparticles offer a very efficient method of getting nutrients into plants, crucially, without the plant having to devote lots of energy to the task. Silicon dioxide nanoparticles, for example, can deliver silicon to your plants without affecting pH, whereas in the past, pH issues have limited the potential benefits. I tested this on basil, growing in NFT, and the results were astounding. I predict that nanotechnology will smash long-established glass ceilings in terms of both yield as well as plant and medicine biofortification. 2017 will finally be the year that home hydroponics goes truly mainstream, and innovative lighting and nutrient solutions will no doubt have a catalytic role to play in this. For my part, I'll have a second grow room up and running in January, so look out for everything I've mentioned getting the Just for Growers treatment very soon. And yes, I'll finally be getting hands-on with the latest LED technologies too. Now, I know that one of the comments that I often get is to slow down, Everest, but I get so excited about these things and have so much to share with you. But for this next segment, I am going to slow it down just a minute because I'd like to extend a massive, heartfelt thank you to everyone who's taken the time to watch my videos and those who take time to start and participate in the discussions. Last but certainly not least, you beautiful subscribers. Those of you who have already clicked that big red button and shown me the greatest love of all, I just want to reach out and give you a big Everest bear hug. You know, subscribing is free and all, but it means a whole lot to me that you care enough to keep tabs on me in your YouTube feed. And speaking of which, make sure you've got notifications turned on so you get a polite ping every time I upload a new video. There'll be plenty more in 2017, I promise. Thanks again for all of your support. Peace, love, and a fertile and productive new year to you all. This is Everest, out.